I don't think I'll ever get bored of that. It's such a thrill to have one that's finally working and does what it's supposed to do when it's supposed to do it. But now we finally got our first sea trials out of the way, and the sea trials went perfectly. I gotta thank everybody who came along for that, the mechanics and everybody who was here to help to make sure if we had any issues, we'd be able to correct them right away. And now we need to move on to the next part of the installation, which is gonna be power production. And that's where this box here is gonna come into play. And this box, as you can see, is from BALMAR. Now this is what's really gonna change our day, and I wanna send out a very special thank you to BALMAR because I contacted them a while ago. I mean, I've told you guys before, I've used BALMAR alternators on my boat for, well, since I've had it, so 17 years that I've used the old engine as a generator, hence why it had 17,000 hours on it. We used it a lot for electricity and refrigeration during the first 10 years that I owned the boat. So that's where all the engine hours came from. But the dual alternators that I had always were BALMAR, and they were between 100 to 120 amps each, so at 12 volts, somewhere around 1,000 to 1,400 watts each. Now, when I got in touch with BALMAR, I told them I was doing a 24 volt system, and they said, well, 24 is okay, but how'd you like to try something really cool? Because they were working on new 48 volt designs, and I was like, 48 volt? Why would anybody use 48, or why would you make 48 volts? Nobody has a 48 volt system. I wasn't really forward thinking at that time, but now I've converted our boat system to 48 volts as the base storage system for charging and huge loads like the inverter. So everything happens again at 48 volts now instead of 24 volts, another time that I've cut the current in half. So a lot less wasted energy just through heat loss in the cables, and we can get away with a lot smaller cables. But of course, I'm still using the same size cables, so they're gonna be a lot more efficient than they used to be. But this new alternator that they designed, oh, they just sent me the first one, and this is it here. Now she's heavy, and she's a pretty good size, but when you consider that, my friends, is a 5 kilowatt direct DC charging 48 volt alternator. So it's rated at 4.8 kilowatts at 48 volts. Now, nominally, this will probably put out around 54 to 56 volts most of the time. So, you know, I'm sure it's gonna be around 5 kilowatts or very close.
If you go directly to BALMAR.net, you can find a list of all the things that BALMAR offers. Just click on the product menu, and if you're interested in what we just got, just click on alternators and look for the 96 series. That will bring you to the basic detail page, and if you scroll down, you'll find this link, which will take you to the high detail page with all the specifications, including the performance curves for these 48 volt alternators. And believe me, they're impressive.
We're gonna get the first one mounted and tested. That's what we're gonna do today, because we need to measure the belt size that we're gonna need. You can see this has the special pulleys on it, so we have to source the belt once we put it on and find out how long a pulley we need. But this alternator, being 48 volts, is one of the first generation of a very high output, high power for charging banks for boaters using lithium. So I'm very happy to be one of the first to use one of these, and not only one, but we're gonna have two in the system when we're finished. That might be a month or two down the road. We're gonna experiment with this one first, and if all is good, we add the second one later. So today, we're gonna add this puppy. Now, as you can see, this alternator has a very, very heavy duty mount on it, 4-inch mount with like, that's like 3/8 of an inch thick solid metal. And if you look on the engine, you'll see these brackets all right here are all the same thing. We just had these custom made by Beta. So these were manufactured in the UK and assembled onto the engine before it was shipped. But these brackets are all custom designed for this particular alternator. So we need to remove these two big bolts here. That's the pivot or the hinge point. And then this arm, we loosen it here and it will come down here. And this is the adjuster, and it has a full torsion adjustment on it right here as well. So that we can tension the belt with this bolt right here and then tighten the whole thing up when it's set. So that's the first thing we're gonna do, is remove all these bolts, put it in the hinge, put the bolts back in, and just start to work with it and see how it's gonna fit best and where the alignment's gonna be and what size of belt we're gonna need. So now, sockets. Okay, so as you can see, we are in business. That went together lickety-split. Absolutely perfect, just like silk. Thank you so much to Beta Marine. They put this whole thing together for us and tested it, test fit it and everything in UK. And it was so easy for us to put together and just assemble. The two bolts went in perfect. There was no problem with clearance and getting at the bolts. The adjuster works perfectly, tensioned the belt. All of our pivots are lined up. We have plenty of clearance on both sides of the alternator, so we'll be able to put a good duct tube right there to blow some cool air on it just to help it ventilate. And then you'll see over on this side, this is the stock alternator here. The stock alternator is going to be removed, and another one of these is going to go in this location. But that's what the secondary mounts are that they built for us. So they custom built all these mounts, and there's another set to go here once we remove this alternator. The second alternator will go here, and it is also on a 6PK belt. You'll see that the inner one, these are all custom machined pulleys that they made for us in UK as well. So we got an 8-inch pulley driving the main alternator out here. There's a 6-inch on the main crank, and that's for the water pump. So this one will spin a little bit slower, but they'll both put out almost the same amount of power. But when we're finished, we're gonna have 4.8 kilowatts here and 4.8 kilowatts here. So almost 10 kilowatts of direct DC output straight into our lithium bank. That's awesome. Thank you so much to BALMAR for your help with this project. Now, the next part of the installation is going to be the electrical. So this is the harness that comes with it and the regulator. So this is one of BALMAR's MC620 regulators, which is tried and tested. They've been using these for years. They're fully gel encapsulated, so they're waterproof, resistant. They can handle heat, temperature, everything you want. You can mount it inside the engine compartment. That's where I used to have mine, but I think this time I might actually mount it outside just so that it's available. I can always read the readout. It has a little digital display to tell you what the settings are, what the temperatures are of everything. So I'm debating keeping this one on the outside, but we'll get to that soon. First, before we hook this up though, I don't want to do any tests with the electrical hooked up with a load on the belt. We're just going to start the engine and make sure the alignment is good. Nothing is jumping, no tension on the pulleys. So that, we're just going to start up here for just a couple seconds and see how it looks. Okay. We got a little bit of flutter there, not too much. So maybe a little bit more tension. That pulley's brand new, so it's going to stretch out over time, but it hasn't been adjusted. Like, we put a regular amount of tension on it, but that's a very, very strong alternator. You got to remember, this alternator, putting out almost 5 kilowatts, it's going to draw somewhere between 8 and 10 horsepower from the engine for each alternator. So when we're just doing full discharge, like full charges, deep charging on the batteries, the two alternators will probably take about 20 horsepower between them running at full output. Which is good, because a lot of the times we're charging, we're just at anchor or something, we're not actually going anywhere, so it still puts enough load on the engine that the engine doesn't just wear from running, you know, freewheeling with not enough load on it. Because that's very bad for diesel engine also, they need to have a load. So this will put at least a 25% load on it, which is perfect. Alright, so we'll shut that down. And we'll put just a little bit more tension. Not too much, but just enough that it's not fluttering, because we don't want this to spin when we start actually running current through there. We want to make sure that everything stays working properly and not just slipping. Because the slipping will generate heat, and that will just overheat the pulley, it'll overheat the belt, it overheats everything, and that's not good. So, yeah, proper tension is very important, but too little tension is bad, too much tension is even worse. So, all right, we'll just adjust that a little bit, and then we'll move on to the next step. Okay, Brian, here's the ratchet or the socket for the top. You got to loosen off this nut here first. Yep, you got it. Okay. Just a couple turns. Okay. That should be good. And now just tighten this one a couple of turns. Okay.
Yeah.
I think so. I don't want to go too tight right off the bat, but we'll monitor the temperature of it with my temperature gauge as we start it up the first time. So we'll probably have to retension it again because obviously it's going to stretch out over time, but that should be good for a first startup.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yep.
Perfecto, gracias. Okay, one more test. First thing we're going to start with the regulator. Well, first of all, you see we got this Ford style connector on here with two harnesses. One of these harnesses has to go to a 12 volt source. You can't hook this up to 48 volts, you'll fry the system, because it's designed to trigger from 12 volts because the starter and the starter battery are 12 volts. So that's the power supply, and this is the ignition wire. So this is going to come from the ignition when the system, when the engine is running. This will switch live. The other connection is this one, and this is the one that has the alternator connections on it. So we have a two-wire connector here, and you see right on the back of the alternator, we have this same female receptacle. So we just plug these two connectors together. Okay. And that is our field wire and our tack wire. So one of them is the one that sends the current to the coil inside the alternator to tell it how much charge to put out according to how many volts are in the batteries already, how much power has already been absorbed. And the other one is a tachometer wire, so that if you've got a digital tachometer up in the cockpit, you can send a feed wire from here that is pulse-based from how fast the alternator is spinning, and it will send that signal up to the tachometer so you know what RPM your engine is running at. So that's already in that harness and hooked up. And then we just have the ground and the positive, which are self-explanatory. We'll put those on when we put the cables on. But before we do those, we're gonna do this. This is one of the most important aspects of the installation, and this is a temperature sensor. So it's a resistive lead that we're gonna hook up to the case of the alternator, and this is an alternator temperature sensor that goes directly to the regulator so that if the alternator exceeds a certain temperature, no matter what's causing it, the regulator will automatically turn down the charging of the alternator to bring it down to a cooler temperature. So very important and a very good feature. But all we need to do that is to hook it up to this case bolt right here. All right, so we got our quarter inch drive set, and we're just gonna go in here and loosen this bolt off. Okay. And twist it out. Pull that all the way out. That through. And put the whole assembly back in. Tighten it up well. Okay. And then we'll run this along with this harness here over to wherever I decide to run the regulator. Okay, so I've got all wires hooked up and accounted for. We got our battery cables hooked up, the negative and the positive. Our connector from the regulator is connected right here. So we got the blue wire and the white wire for the field and the tachometer, but we're not using the tachometer because it's already hooked up through the other alternator that's already installed. Got our fuse on our voltage sense. So this is our voltage sense for the 48 volt line. I just connected it to the battery bus for 48 volts in the boat. Got the temperature sensor installed right here, of course, running through the harness. And the harness is just running to the regulator, which is just forward of here, just floating right now. I'm not installing it until I get everything working and tested. And then we'll figure out the best place for the regulator at the time. So I think we are ready to go. I just need to do some testing right here on the alternator. Negative. Okay, 53.62. You can see right there. So we got our voltage hooked up to the charging bank. That's good. And the batteries are at about 95% right now because the solar panels have already almost finished topping them up. But that should leave enough room that we can accurately test this thing and make sure it's working. So I'm gonna test the voltage at the start battery now also, because this is where the regulator gets its field from, is the start battery. So here's the regulator. And this positive right here should be the 12 volt feed. And yes, we've got 14.28 volts. So we're good to go there. That's perfect. And we test over here the battery sense. This is the charge bank sense wire, so the 48 volt line. Test here and here. And as you can see, 53.6. So we're in good shape. I've already tested the ignition wire. That's hooked up to the engine panel so that whenever the panel is turned on, it has ignition sense into the regulator. So as soon as the control panel turns on, this should turn on. So that's going to be our first test now. We've already checked to make sure all fuses are installed and hooked up. Everything is good. It's 15 amp fuse on the input or the field wire. So the only thing left is to push the button and see if this thing powers up. Ready? And we have power. And we got Balmar, B20, the model, and LFP. So we are in the LIFO 4 program mode. So we're good to go. Now. Okay, so I'll shut that off. Let's have a look at our power panel currently. All right, so yeah, we're at 96%. We're drawing 1200 watts and we're still getting 14, almost 1500 watts of solar up and down, of course, depending on the sun. But you can see right here, we're drawing 200, between 200 and 300, well, 500 now. So it's up and down, but yeah, it seems to be around 200. Depends what the girls are doing in the galley. And let me start it up again. We'll start the engine. Now it has a soft start, so for the first minute it gradually brings the alternator up to power so it doesn't just shock the belt. It lets everything warm up first. So there, you can see it just started. So we're up to 600 watts now, 500 watts. That's just at idle. 700, okay. Maddie? Okay, so it's sitting at about 700-800 right now. I'm gonna go prop it up a little bit. You tell me what the numbers are, okay?
Alternator, I can't believe it. Now, I never expect to get that sustained, but if it still averages between 4,500 and 5,000 at normal operating temperature, that's going to be amazing. Two thumbs up.
Yeah.
Thank you, Balmar. That was an amazing experience. What an amazing first test. The first test results.
We go to the moon.
Well, that's plenty of power, that's for sure. When we put two of those on there, we'll be able to do anything we want. Run air conditioning 24 hours a day, electric galley, no problem. Probably make it all up with one, maybe 2 hours of engine time, so. Excellent. All right, I'm gonna go put it back to idle. We'll shut it down. And, yeah, just check over everything. Jen.
Hey, Mom. There's no aliens in there, though. Yeah.